As you know by now, the Motor Turbo portable and mobile radio supports telemetry. And here we have a DP3600, so it's a portable radio without GPS, but it has a display. And you will see that on it here, under accessories, we've actually got three pins here, which we can assign to telemetry tasks. So there are three options, obviously, telemetry VIO1, and telemetry VIO2, telemetry VIO3. So we could assign those three pins to do a particular task. So here we are saying that on pin 4 we'll have the function of telemetry VIO1. Next that you will see here is the active level. So in order to trigger this telemetry VIO event, the active level must be low. Though telemetry VIO can be an input and it can be an output. So if it is an input, it means to trigger telemetry VIO1, you need to inject an active level low, in other words, ground. If it was set to an output, then triggering telemetry VIO in this radio, so an external trigger to this radio, that means telemetry VIO1 will produce an output on pin 4 of low. So it will transition from a high level down to a low level. The third field here is debounce. Now, this is an old technology, what we call debounce protection. And in the old days, it used to be a capacitor and a resistor. Now what we're doing is we're doing this in software. So let's say, for example, that pin 4 is an input, and that input comes from, say, a relay contact. Now, we know that sometimes with old relays, the contact doesn't close immediately. There is some noise at the beginning of the contact closure. So to prevent accidental triggering of an unwanted event, we will put some debounce protection. So it will ignore the first 100 milliseconds of that trigger. So we've set telemetry VIO1 on pin 4. So what must it do? How do we define whether this is an input or an output? This is done here, if we come to telemetry. So here we have, you can see the entry, telemetry VIO1. And the first thing that we see here is the action. What action must be taken when on telemetry VIO1? So let's say we say this here. So in this case, telemetry VIO is an output. What we can do is from another radio, we can say to this radio, whatever it is, we can send it a telemetry message. Telemetry VIO1, toggle the voltage. What will happen is that another radio will send to this radio this toggle voltage command, and if the active level is low, it will change to a high. If the active level is high, it will change to a low. If we change the voltage from an active high to an active low on pin 4, then what will happen is that the radio will send a toggle voltage command to, and we can specify which radio it is by firstly selecting call mode and call 1, so this can be a name of a radio, and target VIO will be VIO1. So when we change the, when we toggle the voltage on pin 4 of this radio here, it will send a toggle voltage command to this radio here, call 1, it can be a name, and that radio will toggle its telemetry VIO port 1. Okay, so So here we have a basic example of telemetry. We have two users, Radio 1 and Radio 2. The user of Radio 1 presses a button on the radio. This sends a telemetry command to Radio 2, which opens the valve and it starts to fill a tank. The tank gets full and it triggers a float valve on the tank, which sends a command from Radio 2 back to Radio 1. Radio 1 receives this telemetry command and switches on the lamp, and the user then can press the button again, and this will close the valve and will stop filling the tank. We can control simple things like tanks and lights and so forth. This animation and the description is included with the CPS. You will find it in the folder where the CPS is installed, under the folder Samples and Telemetry. There are two sample code plugs for you to have a look at.